Hey guys, it's Lauren Yeates from Rave It Up, and today we have something very exciting to share with you, an exclusive. We're here at Dee Why RSL today to catch up with our buddy Mark Vincent. He's doing a show today and we get to sit in on his sound check and also check out behind the scenes.
No matter what they say, there'll be another day. The sun will come up. Tomorrow starts again. This is not the end.
That's lovely.
Yep.
If we can get that microphone to come down, Jackson.
Just to have that reverb on the tail end of the note.
Yeah, I'm just fixing that.
People talk of revolution. Here it was with the flag.
Yeah, I'm happy. Talking in between song and the verb is still on.
No way.
Oh, good.
No way.
Okay, we looked up there.
Wouldn't it be worse?
I am your father. Maybe a bit more vocal for the house. Have a vocal for me this year.
Well, a while since we've actually sat down and had a chat.
Yes.
But I did see you at Castle RSL, didn't
I? That's right, yes.
Which you did reschedule. Are you okay?
I know, I'm feeling much better now, but as you know, all artists are human and we get sick.
You do get sick.
And I thought it was the best thing to postpone the shows, but thank you for coming and understanding,
welcome.
You know, that we had to change the date, but people were so understanding.
You know what's, like, unfortunate about your job is you can't have an understudy, like musicals or anything? It's only you.
I don't say so. There's only one Mark Vincent.
There's only one Mark Vincent.
No one else can replace me. No. It was a lot of fun to be able to be on stage after being sick, because it's the worst feeling when you're at home not well and you know in your mind, oh, I was supposed to perform tonight.
Yeah, and people are at home. And
you know, people have to reschedule their tickets and come to the, you know, different date of the show, but gratefully worked out at the end, and here we are for the last show.
It was a packed out show too, wasn't it?
All sold out, which was great.
Fantastic. And you were just saying before we started recording that this is like very comfortable, very relaxed before going on stage.
I have
been a lot
better
with that. Is that like a first time thing or?
This last 12 months. Oh, look, I'm a perfectionist, but I think before I used to get very nervous. Backstage. Look, nerves are normal.
Nerves are a good thing, yeah.
And it's good to have nerves. But as you get older, and I'm 25, get older, but you know, you learn to calm yourself more.
Yeah.
And get in that whole mental mode of, okay, I'm going to do a show now. But it's really made me a lot calmer.
Yeah.
Since the more shows I've done, the better it gets, if that makes sense.
Well, I've got to say, for a 25-year-old, and you know, I'm only 24, how much you've achieved at 25, and look at what you're doing at 25. It's incredible.
You're right. Look,
keep
to be able to do what you love,
yeah.
That's what it's all about. And music is my life. I love singing. And you know, I said to my wife just recently, to be able to do this for a job, it's not even a job. It's everything to
me.
It's
just fun on stage.
Oh, it is fun, you know, and that's how it should be. And I think when artists sometimes get locked in that mode of, oh, this is a job. You have to remember that music's much more than that. It fills people's souls, you know, and
people,
I love it.
People come just to kind of get away from their life, right?
Correct.
And
get away from the politics of life and come to a show where you've kind of in that own world space of happiness when you listen to music.
Especially the music you do. Oh, last time I saw you live, I was like, I've just forgotten about all my problems. This is great.
Oh, well, look, that's what I try to do when people come to a show. Because I always, like, for example, the last show I did was that election time, who was going to be Prime Minister.
Yep, and you made a couple of jokes.
Yeah, that's right. Good old Scott Morrison, but congratulations to Scott Morrison. But the thing is, I said to people, this is a free election zone. You know, because at the end of the day, I love people to get away from all the politics, as I said, and come to a night of music and have some fun. Yeah. That's what it's about.
Exactly. And obviously, I'm not going to chat to you right before you go on stage, but we'd love to know, do you have any like pre-show rituals or anything like that, or you just get your voice warmed up?
Well, here's an example. What I usually do, this is the set list for...
Exclusive.
Marsha, you can see that. So we've got Somewhere, Tonos Oriento, Funiculi, all of those Neapolitan classics and musical theatre songs. Like Delilah as well, which is my Tom Jones favourite. But I go through this list of songs, get my head around it all.
And memorise them.
Memorise it, don't get the words wrong. And then obviously get in that show mode, do some warm-ups backstage, drink plenty of water.
Yes,
H2O. Back to you, Larry. Yeah, but that's what I do. Just get in that mental space of, okay, I'm about to do a show.
And Clarissa Spata, she is incredible.
Opera Australia, she's fantastic.
You do a beautiful duet with her as well.
Amigos para siempre.
Yeah.
Oh, her voice is phenomenal. It's so strong and, you know, she's really... It's about that connection between each artist.
Yeah.
And we have that.
Have you guys been friends for a long time? Or
we have.
Friends for life.
So the song is definitely truthful because it's that mutual respect between the two of us.
Yeah.
And the audience can see that. Would you agree?
Absolutely.
They feel that energy.
Yeah. Okay. Well, I hope to have a little chat to her later on too.
Yes.
See her out there. So.
You want me to chat to Joe as well? Joe McAree, my musical director. He's been touring with me since I was 16.
Oh, so there'd be some stories.
Oh, he's put up with me over the years.
So Joe, maybe I shouldn't
chat to him. I can't, you know. So, but I'm blessed to have a good team around me. Because you can't do it alone.
No.
You need that support.
Yeah. And that's what's keeping you humble as well and keeping you going as well.
That's
awesome.
Right.
So obviously we've chatted about pre-show rituals and you need your H2O. Is there anything else that you like request backstage?
No burgers or chips or any of that stuff because you don't want that coming up on stage. So.
No, not really.
But pretty much just water. Lots of water, lots of fluids, and staying relaxed as possible.
Hairspray.
Oh, yes.
Hairspray and deodorant, pretty important.
If I went out in the blizzard, this hair wouldn't go anywhere. I just got this.
Well, it's the super strong one, too.
We can't forget deodorant either.
Yes.
So... No, but again, I'm super excited for today.
Yeah, well, thank you for having us here.
No, it's a pleasure.
Wish we did the Castle RSL one, but it's been great to come out again.
You've been part of this journey.
Exactly, and in a way it was great because then I could see your show first and then come again and go, okay, now I know exactly what I'm going to ask and got to check out Clarissa as well because I hadn't heard of her before. Now I do. So everyone check her out as well.
Yes.
And go grab your tickets to Mark's shows all around the country.
All on the website.
You will not regret it because it's an amazing show. And
I'm touring with Lunza now. Doing a tribute show for Lunza.
You are.
Through Victoria, through the South Coast. So I'm very excited about that.
And you've announced you're doing another tour in November as well.
Yes.
Oh, my goodness.
Touring nationally in Australia at the end of the year, which is very exciting. It's a big step, but what's most exciting is I'll be going to Italy in September.
Oh, my goodness.
To perform with Catherine Jenkins.
Actually preparing for all of this?
Like, I don't know, to be honest.
As well as getting to do like another show tonight, then you've also got to think about all that coming up.
That's what makes it all fun. They say it's a game, and it's true. You know, it's about how much can your mental capacity handle, you know, with all these different songs, different places, travelling. But as I said, I'm blessed to be able to do what I do.
Travel the world and sing songs.
It's very exciting.
It is.
So,
hopefully we can expect another album as well in the future.
Yes, hopefully next year, Mother's Day. Fingers and toes.
Hey, keep a lookout for that, guys.
Yes.
And come back on the show anytime. You're always welcome because we just
love
you.
And so are you. Thank you for your support.
You're welcome.
I appreciate it.
I'm happy to come anytime. You just call me up and go, Lauren, get to this gig.
Come on, I'll come to Italy, Rome.
If you're paying for the plane ticket, sure, I will come. I would love to.
Yes.
Just say bye, guys, to Mark. Care. We'll be obviously seeing him on stage and everything, but other than that, he's got to get mentally prepared for the show.
Thanks,
prepared.
Everyone. Bye.
There we go. A woman that
I might just slide on it.
Another dressing room now. I've got Clarissa Spata,
hi.
Mark's amazing support act, and she's agreed to have a little chat with me quickly. All right, so first thing I've really got to ask, I don't know whether you're going to tell us or anything, but you and Mark have been friends for a while now.
Yeah.
Do you have any, like, juicy goss you can share with us? No, oh, he's a lovely man.
He's lovely.
I couldn't think of anything bad you're going to say about him.
Oh, no. The only thing I'll say is we get along so well because we both love food. We're both Italian background.
Yes.
We both love food. So we were like, I think we both work out a lot, but then we both eat a lot. So touring with him is fun.
You got to fight over food when you got to do your
not
show.
Not that bad, but it's great. It's like, you know, he enjoys life and it's a lot of fun.
And your beautiful duet out there.
Oh.
Is that like... Obviously, it's so beautiful to watch as an audience member.
Thank you.
But when you're doing sound check,
I promise we'll be more like professional in this show. We'll be like, it's a bit of like it's like a bit of a samba going on.
Yeah, you have a bit of a fun and a bit of a laugh.
Yeah, look, it's great. He's
how do you not like break out into laughter then when you?
We do. We're on stage, yes.
Trying to be professional.
It's sometimes quite hard because, especially with a song like that, because you know you're like. Hey.
Friends forever.
Yeah, but no, it's great. Like, or sometimes you just give a little laugh or a little, you know, and then you just have to take all your control. Don't love him.
Damn you, Mark. I'll get you back.
He's got a great smile, so he's really cheeky, you know.
Yeah. And something I'm very jealous of, and I just could not get over when I did watch the show, because I came to Castle RSL,
I think
we chatted about that, was these beautiful dresses that she has. Oh my goodness, especially that black one in the corner.
Oh,
where did you buy them? And yeah, is there just three costume changes or you do more?
No, I did. Well, I did two to three. Sometimes like, I put something on it, you know, just make sure it works.
Yes.
But your favorite one is when I was, I'd won an opera scholarship and I studied in New York. And I bought that in New York.
Oh.
I'd saved up. This was my own pocket money that I bought.
While she's talking, let's go have a little walk. Beautiful.
Lots of sparkles.
Oh. Oh, anyway. Yep.
Yeah.
I'm mesmerized.
And
you may need to double check that it's still there when I leave.
I just love it. The thing is, you run out of gowns to wear because I have to think to myself, okay, this venue.
Did I wear?
What did I wear? Because, and what did I sing? So, so I'm like, these three I haven't worn before, so I'm okay. But I literally go through the closet and go, oh, no, I can't wear that. I can't wear that.
So as well as your set list, you have to also write down what dress
honestly,
I wore.
Honestly, you know, if it wasn't for a friend taking a photo the last time I was here, I actually thought I wore that one last time, but I didn't. So I'm okay.
Don't tell them.
She's in that same dress.
Oh, no, who cares? You look beautiful in it. You don't really mind.
No, bless. Oh, look, I try and like change them around so people don't get bored. But also, I don't get bored. You know,
Do? Yeah, that's probably more like it. Just because they might have come to another show, might not have been in the same venue.
That's it.
Yeah. I'd love to know as well, do you have any like pre-show rituals as well? Just warm up your voice? Or...
Definitely, yeah. Warm up. A lot of water, I should say. A lot of water before you sing. And I just try and I go through the dialogue before. because for me, you know, having to speak and not run over my words, yeah, because you do, you finish a high note, and you're like, all the blood rushes to my head. I don't know what happens to tenors, but I'm just like, and then I'm like, speak slowly. So that's what you'll find me doing. Usually I go through that, and then I'll do a little, you know,
because I guess you're used to the actual singing on stage, not the real talking. Yeah, we do that all the time. Yeah, but talking, you're like, I got to do what?
I have to talk now. It's not scripted.
No.
So a lot of that, and just also going over the running orders, like you were teasing me before. I was
memorizing.
I can't talk and do the order at the same time. Like,
no. because if you don't have it memorized, you'd be thinking you're going to come on the stage to do one song and you're actually doing another one.
I had a different show yesterday. So the thing is, you really have to go, what's today?
Yeah. How do you actually pick what songs you want in each set and where you want to put them? Do you have a specific way?
That's actually a really good question. Well, I try and open with something a bit punchy and uplifting, you need to. But
as a support act, you need to.
Yeah, because you hear people like, rah, you know, and they don't even realize you're starting. So you're like, I'm here, hi. Hi, everyone, it's just me. And then usually I'll try and close with something quite punchy as well.
But in between, it doesn't really matter
anymore. No, you got to like build a story. So as long as you can work out what your story is when you're talking about what the songs are, linking them together. So, for example, you know, Phantom of the Opera. It's good to do Think of Me, you know, next to it because you're talking about that particular thing instead of taking Think of Me and throwing it in the second half, and
putting it in a different order.
I try and be a bit logical.
That's awesome. And they're all your favourite songs? You just picked your favourite ones and chuck them in?
They're my favourite songs. Oh, absolutely. You know, you don't get sick of singing them or hearing them. And my favourite is when you announce the title of the song and they go, and then
they know the song. They're going to hopefully sing along with
me. But sometimes they don't. Sometimes they don't know the song, so they just go, okay. You know, okay, we'll let you entertain us.
But in your mind, you'll be like, I'll amaze you. Just wait a second. I did ask Mark this question as well when I got to have a chat to him. Do you request anything backstage? You've obviously got your little sandwiches over there for later on, but anything else? And water.
You know, I'm pretty easy. I hear a lot of things that people request, but
Diva demands.
Oh, yeah. No, room temperature water. So
I went and grabbed it
out of the thing.
And someone was like, yeah, Mark has room temperature water.
It's still cool.
Yeah.
But this was the, like, warmest one I could get. So I'm probably not meant to advertise which it is. But just saying.
Some H2O somewhere.
Room temperature water because you don't want anything too cold. But if we're lucky enough to have a kettle, I just love herbal teas and things like that. But it just depends where you are. I'm so easygoing.
But there's no kettle here, so.
No. Look, I even brought my own little steamer.
Oh, that's so nice.
Oh, no.
And your big bag of everything.
Oh, I nearly didn't make it here. I was like, I need help carrying things sometimes, but you know, what do you do?
You should have just asked someone to come out. I would help you.
So I'm like, everyone knows they're like, singing tonight, you know, when you turn up, you're singing tonight. Oh, you must be the singer.
Yes. No, I've come here just for lunch. And I just want to bring my whole life.
Mess up a workout for
Good luck tonight.
Thank you.
You actually gave me goosebumps last time. That's She's how very good nice you are.
To me.
Oh, no, I mean it. Absolutely. Just ask my friend that I brought. I was like, God, this girl.
Oh, that means so much.
Well, afterwards we're like, okay, we need to Google this woman and check her out. And so go check her out, guys. If you're not going to come to the show, which I hope you are, go check her out online.
As I said, she's very nice.
I'm telling the truth.
But sure, check me out online.
And we've had a chat about you coming on the show for an actual interview, because this is just a fun little chat just before you go on stage.
It's like talking to my best friend. How easy is this?
Exactly. So, that's how all my interviews are. So that makes you want to come on. So we're going to bring you on the show very soon, so keep a lookout for that, guys. And as we mentioned when we were chatting to Mark, buy your tickets now and check them out live, especially the duet.
We'll make it extra good for you.
Yes. It's not extra good anyway.
But we've got to like take note of which dresses I've just put on, and then we can't do that in the show you come to, so you know, I'll
try. Well, you've got video evidence of this now. You've got the red, you've got the black, and you've got the purple. Don't wear that again.
No, don't wear that again. Terrible.
I'll go shopping with you.
Yeah.
Let's buy some new dresses. Yes.
This is my cameraman Farhan, by the way.
Hello.
His first little mini vlog.
What? It's my debut.
It's your debut. He's always behind the camera.
I bought the Politics Shiny, a different one, yep. And I bought this one, whatever you want it. Yeah, so it's up to you what you want to mix with.
Hello! Oh, look at that beautiful! Oh my god. I'm so jealous. Isn't she beautiful?
I'm full of compliments.
She's the best. She's if you ever your best need... friend. I'm stealing her.
I went to go get you Nurofen. Like,
yes, you did. I am the me. New best now friend. I can sing because of you. I'm gonna stop your hair, sorry.
That's okay.
It's the jewelry. Take a look at that jewelry.
I know. You know, someone once said to me, you shouldn't wear like so much. You're so meant much. To take something off, but I'm like,
does it ever get stuck to the dress? I always find that I, whenever I wear dresses.
These shoes get stuck to the material as well. So sometimes on stage, if you ever see me do this,
you know why. Okay. Yeah. Well, we've got our little position right next to the, on the stage, oh, on the side of the stage.
So,
to your, when you're looking at the crowd to the right.
I'll keep you.
Yeah. Give me a wink.
Yeah. Well, good luck.
Thank you, beautiful. So I'm my new best friend now. Yeah.
Enjoy the show.
I will. Everyone enjoy the show too.
Please don't sing along. And I'm serious. Don't sing along because you're going to ruin the whole thing. I've rehearsed this with Anthony Waller and I don't want any interruptions, so please. I'm only kidding. Well, everyone still got it? I'm 25, there's something wrong if it's not me. Well, everyone, this is my last song for the first half. All right, today.
So the show is finished. What did you think, Farhan?
Amazing.
And great experience for you. That was like his first sound check behind the scenes to film. What and you amazing. Finally have a That's face all. Face to the name that always pops up at the end of the videos. But everyone, go support Mark. He absolutely is incredible, as you can probably already tell from the videos. Even better live. Other than that, make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Check us out on our website, raveituptv.com. And support us as well. But for now, thanks for watching, guys. And we'll see you next time. Bye!